Dr. Mindy here, and all this week I am talking about your fat burning hormone and giving you guys the tools to use fasting, diet, sleep, and I've got another tool today I'm going to reveal to you in this video on how you get out of leptin resistance. So if you are new to my channel, I just want to say welcome. Super happy you're here. I am on a mission to teach a million people this year how to build a fasting lifestyle. What I love about a fasting lifestyle is that it taps into your own healing power. You don't need to have a lot of money. You don't need to have a lot of time. You just need the knowledge. And that's what I'm trying to do here on this channel, is give you that knowledge. So welcome. And as always, if you love it, send it out into the world so we can get everybody healthy and immune strong. Okay, this video is so needed. So stick with me as I walk you through this process. So the first thing I want you to know is that when we come to fasting and the ketogenic diet, or any version of the ketogenic diet, we get really excited about this idea of fat burning. But what I want you to know is you're not meant to be a fat burner all the time. And when it comes to leptin resistance, leptin again being your fat burning hormone, when it comes to leptin resistance, fasting isn't enough. Keto isn't enough. What you've got to do is you've got to get yourself in a state of metabolic switching. So there is a really interesting study that I'm linking in the notes that is showing that intermittent metabolic switching will increase a protein in your body called BDNF. So brain-derived neurotrophic factor. And BDNF is like a brain fertilizer. It's like miracle grow for your brain. And it'll help you grow new neurons. This is fabulous for when you want to improve memory. This is amazing for those of you that are learning, maybe you're in school or you're studying for a test. You want to get a lot of BDNF. But what this study shows is that BDNF has to come through going in and out of states of sugar burning and fat burning. And what is so important about this is that not only do you have to switch in and out of these two states to get BDNF, but as BDNF goes up, guess what hormone goes down? Leptin. So all this week, I'm bringing you the strategies to kick yourself out of leptin resistance. So if we want to get BDNF, then we're going to need to go in and out of these two states. And I want to read you something from the study. This is actually a line from the study. It said that intermittent metabolic switching is repeating cycles of metabolic challenge that induces ketosis, that's fat burning, and they put in parentheses, the challenge is fasting or exercise. So you need to put yourself in a fasted challenge or you need to put yourself in an exercise challenge in order to tap into the ketogenic pathway for energy. And then it goes on to say, but then you have to follow that with a recovery period. And the recovery period is when you're eating, you're resting, or you're sleeping. So go back to the video I did on sleep. There were three things I taught you guys that are really important to know about sleep when it comes to leptin. So in order to get BDNF to go up and leptin to come down, you can't just fast. You got to do metabolic switching. So now, what exactly does BDNF do other than lower leptin? There are two other things it does for your weight loss efforts. One is it suppresses your appetite. Okay, that's going to be really helpful, right? So if I'm going to try fasting or get over into this ketogenic pathway, I got to make sure that my hunger is down. The second thing is it lowers leptin. And then the third thing is it regulates your blood sugar better. It is literally like this miracle protein that you're going to want to access. So how do you access it? How do we get you in and out? Well, if you go back to the video I did on Monday, I talked about how dry fasting is an incredible way to increase BDNF. But what I didn't perhaps tell you in a deeper part of that story is that dry fasting, specifically when they studied it in the parameters of Ramadan, is that dry fasting will increase BDNF. But what do they do in Ramadan? What do they do when they're dry fasting? They're eating in the morning, they're dry fasting all day long, and then they're eating at night. So they're going into a metabolic stress, and then they are going into a recovery period. So the first thing, if you want to bring BDNF up, is you need to do a fast. Intermittent fasting's fine. Autophagy fasting's great. You can pair any fast. But then you want to go into a recovery period. And you want it to ideally not be a ketogenic recovery. So going into a fasted state and then recovering with a low-carb diet, that might not do it. So what you've got to do is get yourself over into more of a sugar burner. Doesn't mean you're going to do a fast and then go to McDonald's or eat a big piece of cake, but something like applying all the principles I taught you this week, you could go into the carnivore diet, or you could go into a hormone building day, like for women in menopause that I've taught you guys how to use hormone building techniques, or protein cycling. You could fast for 15 hours and then decide that you're going to recover with protein cycling. So there's a lot of ways that you can use these principles to switch in and out. But if you had a test that showed your leptin was high, you're gonna wanna get BDNF high. If you know your leptin's high, you're really struggling to lose weight, you wanna get BDNF high. And in the fasting principle that will get BDNF high is the metabolic switching. Okay, how else do we get good BDNF? And that really comes from something called HIIT training. It's an exercise. And what's interesting about HIIT training is, what are you doing? You're going into periods of stress. That's what this study showed. It's where you're like doing a jumping jack as fast as you can, or you're running in place as fast as you can. I recommend you do it for 30 seconds and then you recover for 90 seconds. You can do less than that if you want, but that's just something for a beginner to do. You could go 30 seconds on, recover for 90. In our my Reset Academy, every Saturday morning we work out together, and I always put people through a 45 seconds on, so we're metabolically stressing the body for 45 seconds, and then we recover for 15. So if you want to pull yourself out of leptin resistance, then you want to make sure that you're pushing yourself hard enough and then recovering. What wouldn't pull you out of leptin resistance with exercise is getting on the treadmill and running at the same rate the whole time. You're just burning calories. And we've already decided that insulin and leptin resistance, they don't care about your calories. They care about metabolic flexibility. So if you want to use exercise as a tool to get yourself out of leptin resistance, you're gonna need to get that heart rate up and down where you push it and then you rest. So really interesting study. I will link it in the notes. More and more I dive into this information, the more convinced I am that we are meant to have our cake and eat it too. And I mean that, where we're meant to fast, but then we're also meant to go through feast periods. We're meant to work out really hard and we're meant to rest. So we've got to use all of these tools to learn again. We have to learn over again how this body wants us to treat it. And we've gotten so far off course because we get up, we eat all day, we don't think about ever getting into the metabolic pathway of the ketogenic pathway. We just eat all day, we don't think about what we're eating, we think about what our taste buds want, we're not moving. The human race right now, we don't have these metabolic switching periods. And it's in that switch where the magic happens. So, as always, I hope that helps. Let me know if you have any questions, because this video, I know it's a little more deep, but I want you to grab it. And as always, if you want the companion guide for Fast Training Week this week with all this information on there, just put companion guide and we'll make sure you get it. Hope that helps.